Hey guys, Adam Savage here at the Smithsonian Air and Space Museum. We are here filming some stuff for Tested and some other stuff, but we had a few minutes to kill and I wandered over into this zone, of course, because there's a couple of amazing spacesuits to talk about. First up, we have David Scott's Apollo 15 suit. I think I started off wrong. Here's the way I want to talk about this. There is so much really interesting engineering between these two suits and what's going on with spacesuit research today. So this is David Scott's Apollo 15 lunar suit. Our old Tested friend, the late Al Warden, actually was the pilot on Apollo 15. David wore this on the moon, and this is the A7LB version of ILC's Dover's moon suit. This was, at the time, the very latest in spacesuit engineering, and still, the astronaut, after donning the suit and the boots and the gloves and the helmet, had a backpack to put on that connected up with connectors over here. A lot of equipment had to get bolted together for the astronaut to be safe. Now, here is the Russian Krashet moon suit. This is from the 60s. And obviously it looks very different, but also structurally from an engineering standpoint, it is very different inside. Unlike the moon suit, it has a hard shell inside. NASA wouldn't go to hard upper torsos until the space shuttle days when they began to build the EMUs with what they called HUTs, hard upper torsos. But the most, for me, my favorite part about this one, you see how the backpack opens up like a door? That is how you get into this suit, is one point of entry. That's it. That is brilliant simplicity, and we wouldn't take on that idea at NASA until only about a decade or so ago. And our new Artemis suits, the XEMUs that they are currently working on to get to the moon, those are built this way with a rear entry integrated backpack. Now NASA's backpack has this beautiful sort of toothed belt design for closing it really, really securely. But I also really love looking at this one and seeing the Russians like really simple two fins that go into two large O-rings, basically like a refrigerator door, and the astronaut is sealed inside. Now, for a lovely bit of symmetry, the Russian name for this suit translates to Golden Falcon, and the Apollo 15 crew flew to the moon on a ship named the Falcon. The other thing about this hard parts inside the suit versus a soft suit, that idea of a hard versus a soft anthropomorphic spacesuit describes a tension inside every space program about how to design something that is rigid and controllable for someone, yet easy for them to move around. How do you add hard parts when every human being is a completely different size? I mean, we've done millions and millions of dollars of research, the military, NASA, only to find out that there is no such thing as an average human being. And so it is really, really difficult to make hard parts fit soft bodies. And these are two iterations along that long timeline. And it is a problem that is still being solved. Given that I've spent the last month of my life obsessively replicating a couple of XEMUs, I am most fascinated by the stand here. I really like the Russians' design of a rolling stand for getting into this suit. It's elegant, it's lightweight, you can see the whole suit, it gives you access 360 around the whole thing and yet holds it really nicely. I may eventually make myself one of these. I can't get enough of thinking about, researching, replicating, and talking about the anthropomorphic spaceships that humans have built to survive the rigors of space, and getting to see them up close is always a treat.